Good morning, class. I know it's super duper early, but I have an important thing to talk to you about. Cheesecake. Now, everybody knows what cheesecake is, right? It's like a staple dessert in the American diet. But what do we really know about cheesecake? Like, what do we know about its history, its conception, how it's made, where it even comes from? And for all we know, I don't know. It could have been made by cheese. Cheese, big cheese people. Maybe. I don't know. Now let's begin with the origins of this famous dessert. Cheesecake is thought to have been around for a long ass time, dating all the way back to the ancient Greeks, and it could be one of the oldest desserts that's still around today. They were whipping up cheesecakes as far back as 2000 BC, and this food blog that I found on the internet told me that the first Olympics back in 776 BC had competitors on an exclusively cheesecake diet to optimize performance levels. It said that in this time period, the Greeks used cheese, honey, and wheat flour to make cheesecakes, which sounds kind of terrible, but to each their own. When the Romans ended up conquering Greece, they added crushed eggs and milk into the cheesecake recipe and would cook it underneath a hot brick. Now, I don't know what they mean by crushed eggs. I'm hoping they didn't include the shells. That'd be really bad. When the first cookbook in history was printed in 1545, cheesecakes were described as flour-based sweet food. At the time, chefs serving royal families would spend hours perfecting cheesecakes according to their own ideas. It wouldn't be until the 18th century that the cheesecake styles modern society recognized today would finally begin to take shape. In 1872, some dude was trying to replicate some sort of French cheese and ended up accidentally making the famous Philadelphia cream cheese. Crazy. And this beautiful creation started being integrated into cheesecake and has led to the amazing cheesecake that we know today. The cheesecake that I'm making today is a special kind known as the New York style cheesecake. Now, what's the difference between New York style and regular cheesecake?
Cream.
New York style essentially just has a lot more cream cheese and eggs, which gives it a smooth and creamy consistency. There's honestly too much cheesecake history to reasonably cover in this video, so we're gonna have to move on to the kitchen to watch me hopefully bake a cheesecake successfully. Starting out, you're gonna want to set your oven to 375 degrees. I'm actually not in my own kitchen. My kitchen was under renovation, and I currently have no counter and no cabinets, and everything's strewn about. This is me applying foil to the pan. You want to apply like about 2 sheets of foil to the pan. I had a small bit of trouble getting it on there properly, but it's fine. I was actually using the wrong type of pan. The pan that you're supposed to be using is actually a springform pan, and I didn't know where to find one of those, so I decided to use a little bread pan and make a deep dish cheesecake, which honestly ended up pretty good, in my opinion. Now, here I am spraying the crap out of it with a cooking spray. Here's the bowl where I'm gonna start mixing everything. That's my graham cracker mix that I blended in a food processor. And I'm adding the graham cracker in, adding some sugar. Tyler had these like really cute little like kitty tablespoons, and they're adorable. They were so great to use. They had no handles though, so that made them a little difficult to use. Adding some salt, about half a teaspoon of salt, adding the butter, and then I'm gonna end up mixing it all up. I made actually way too much of this to the point where I just had a bowl where I just ate some, which I found it was a really enjoyable snack while making it. You mix it until like just combined. It smelled amazing. It smelled so good. It was the best smell ever. It reminded me of like cream cheese cherry pie. And then you pack it into the bottom of your pan, just on top of the foil, and you stick it in the oven for 10 minutes and then let it set or whatever. And now here I am moving on to the filling. You need 32 ounces of cream cheese, which is like four 8 sticks of cream cheese, because these are four. There's 4 2-packs. I had a bit of trouble getting the cream cheese out, if I'm being honest. It was pretty difficult. And then my timer for the thing went off, so I had to go take the crust out. We didn't have any oven mitts on hand, so I just had to use a towel.
That's good.
And then add the flour. You only need 3 tablespoons of flour, which was kind of surprising. But I guess since it's like a cheesecake, mixing that thing up. This was actually probably the most difficult part of the whole thing, because just the consistency. Tasted really good though. The recipe called for 8 teaspoons, which is like almost 3 tablespoons of vanilla extract. And I felt really bad for using my mom's stuff, so I only did 4. And I didn't want it to be like overpowering. And now I'm moving on to the lemon zest. This was also a painful process, because I didn't actually have a zester. I had to use that cheese grater triangle thingy. And then the recipe called for an entire lemon squeezed into the thing, so that's probably why it tasted really lemony. Here I am adding one of those 6 eggs, mixing it in. You're supposed to mix each egg in individually, and then you end up getting this really good batter consistency. Very liquidy, very yellow, very cheesecake-like. It smelled really good as well. It was really just all coming together, and I was really proud of myself. And then you add cream cheese, or not cream cheese, sour cream. And I'm assuming it like curdles when you bake it, and that's what makes it all cheesy. Cheese-like, I guess. Mix that thing in, get it all mixed up. The thing with cheesecakes is it actually tells you to boil a pot of water in a kettle, and then you pour it into the pan around it. Poured all my batter in. For me, this was kind of dangerous because I only had a pan, and then I had like a bigger bread pan to put my smaller bread pan in. And so the boiling water was a little scary for me personally. I decided to just take the bread pan out, pour the water in, and then stick the bread pan back in. And then you just insert it into the oven and then let it cook for an hour and a half to an hour and then 40 minutes. Putting that into the oven was probably the most nerve-wracking part of it. I was so afraid I was going to drop it and spill something everywhere. And then you just kind of take it out of the oven. This was 11 p.m. at night, so I was a bit tired, but it ended up coming out really good. It said that when you take it out of the oven, it should be able to jiggle a little bit when you mess with it, when you poke it. And then that's the finished cheesecake product. It actually tasted so amazing. My whole entire family loved it. It looks like a hobo cheesecake, which goes with my menu theme, which is just a hobo restaurant outside the back of the Empire State Building.